So I've got the JAWS screen reader enabled on my computer right now, and I wanted to just give you an idea of what it's like to be running JAWS and have this one's the user way accessibility menu, the widget installed. It's the same concept for Accessibility or any of these other ones. Hopefully the thing will work with all my recording going on. So if I open up a new page, you'll see how it sounds with both of them together.
Leaving menus, IntelliWolf-WordPress web design and coding tutorials-Google Chrome, IntelliWolf. How to connect grab open access, how to how to connect gravity forms.
Press enter to skip to main content.
Press enter to enable accessibility for visually and press enter to open the user way accessibility menu. Enter. Press enter to open the user way accessibility menu.
Press enter to enable keyboard navigation.
Read page toggle.
Press enter to enable the screen reader.
Press contrast plus
press enter to enable enhanced contrast.
Press space bar.
So I don't need to go through all of these. I think you get the idea. That female voice that comes from UserWay, any of them have the same thing. So you've got the JAWS going on reading the what's going on, and then you've also got the UserWay reading each of the things. So just on that alone, like if you closed your eyes and tried to imagine navigating through a website that you'd never seen before, that would be somewhat of a nightmare having both of those going together. And this is just a default install for UserWay. Maybe there's a way of turning that off if you use the premium version. I'm not sure. I've not used the premium version. I've just used the free version. But then, so for each of those pages, you can have that issue for the accessibility menu. So then if you need a screen reader to access a page, then one would imagine that you would have a screen reader, whether that's on your phone or on the computer or whatever, in which case there's not really any need for having a read the page button on the accessibility menu. Then you've got things like keyboard navigation. Well, if your website is set up properly, then you don't need keyboard navigation, and if it's not, then the keyboard navigation isn't actually going to work the way that someone who has visibility issues is going to expect that the website will be navigable. Same thing with contrast. Honestly, you should have your website just set up for contrast as it is, and yeah, using the contrast from any of these accessibility widgets, it should work for everyone as it is. Same with highlight links, you should have those underlined or obvious links, bigger text that if someone needs bigger text, then they can just make it bigger themselves. Or more likely what's happened is that they've set up their browser on their phone or whatever so that they can so that it displays larger text, stopping the animations, all those sort of things. They should all be done on the website themselves. Things like alt text and all that kind of stuff. These accessibility widgets aren't going to fix any of those. So honestly, just build your website the right way and you won't need this. And in fact, if someone needs assistance with going through a website, then as you heard, if you're using one of these accessibility menus, that's actually going to make the experience significantly worse to the point where they're just not going to be able to use it. It's as bad as if you didn't have anything on there and had poorly programmed the website. So just for my own entertainment. Let's go through a couple more.
Links highlighted, highlight links toggle button to toggle. Bigger text is enabled, text spacing toggle button.
And of course now the female voice has stopped. I think it doesn't like running with the recording software, but at least you heard it at the start. So that's all I've got for you today. I'll see you in the next one.